Smart Suite just released a new action for its automation. We can now get really creative using webhook actions natively inside of Smart Suite automations. This opens up a world of possibilities, but it's a little on the complicated side. We're going to break it down step by step in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. Smart Suite is one of our favorite no-code tools in 2024 and beyond. Now, in this video, we're going to be diving into this brand new webhook action step that we can put into our native Smart Suite automations, allowing us to do more than ever before. Before I get into the heart of the video, though, I first want to invite you to join me for general automation training. If you are newer to no-code tools, you are going to love what automation can do for you. I'm going to break it all down for you. Regardless of the tool you use, automations are built the same way, and I teach that in my free training. You can grab it at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Sign up there, get immediate access to the training. Without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. I want to invite you to follow along with me. If you already have a Smart Suite, open it up, follow these steps. If you don't, please consider signing up using our affiliate link that I will share below. So what are we working on? Here's our very high-level scenario. Imagine that we get some information about prospective clients, and I've got three examples listed here, just the name of the company as well as the website of the company. And so we want to take this information. Maybe this is all we get in terms of prospective clients, and we need to enrich this data. I want to know how many followers do they have. This is a number field that I've built inside of Smart Suite. And I also want to know what type of company is it? Is it a public company? Is it privately held? Give me the information I need about this company. Now, there are a lot more layers that we could do here. This is a very high level example. Of course, we could enrich data in a number of different ways, but this is just that. It's an example. There are so many different things we can do with webhooks actions. So this is, again, merely an example, but let's dive into this exact thing. So what we might do is find an open API out there on the internet somewhere in the cloud where we can ping it with a webhook and say, hey, we want to get information back from you. We're sending you this information, this stuff right here, the company name and the website, and we want to get that data enrichment. Well, there is exactly such a tool, and this particular video isn't necessarily about this tool, but I need to bring this up because this is what we're using for the video. It's called enrich.so. If you want to go ahead and sign up just to follow along with me here, they're going to give you 25 free pings, free webhook actions you can take, so you don't even have to start paying until you get to a certain level. This might help you with data enrichment in your own company. So we go ahead and sign up here. I've already created my free account. You can see we have some credits here. And ultimately what we need to do is build our connection. So I'm going to break down how we do this inside of Smart Suite's new automations. Now, first and foremost, I need to determine my trigger. For me, it's going to be when I push this button. When I say I want to update data, that's what's going to send the information out there to the enrich.so, and I want to get that information back. So inside of Smart Suite, I go ahead and open up here and go to my automations. And I built the beginnings of this automation already. And here I'm saying, I want to trigger this when a record matches conditions. This is really straightforward. I simply say, look, when that little update data is toggled on, then I want to do the magic. I want to send this information and I want to get information back. And so now we're able to build this brand new action step inside of Smart Suite automations called Send Webhook Request. So here I've built it up for us. Let me show you how I got all of this information step by step. So the first step is to decide where are we sending this information. Obviously, this is very important. This is the destination for the request. So if we flip back into Enrich, we see here when we're looking at our information, it gives us the address that it wants us to send to. You will notice, though, that this is a little bit longer than what I've included, and that's because part of this is static, part of it is dynamic. We are sending to this address right here. After the question mark on my screen, everything following that is a variable. I'm going to pass additional URL parameters or variables into that URL. So all I need is everything before the question mark. That is api.enrich.so, and then it ends with company. So Over here, I have pasted that into my request URL. Now it's time for the HTTP method type. What exactly are we doing with this request? Well, we have options. We can do a GET request and a POST request. These are the two most common. A PUT, DELETE, or PATCH are also available inside of Smart Suite webhook actions. For us, we're choosing a GET, which means we are going to send information in both headers and URL parameters, and we are not including a body for this. We are going to get information back, and we're going to be able to use that in the next step. So we've chosen the GET HTTP method. Now it's time for our headers. In order to understand our headers, let's flip back now into our setup, and you can see that this particular system has already identified two headers for us: authorization, which takes bearer and then our personalized token, and then also content type, which is application/JSON, which is pretty typical, pretty common. So we're going to just copy both of these things, content type, exclude the colon here, and we're going to bring it back over here and create that header, application JSON, just as it said on the previous page. Same thing with authorization, we just copy it, and then we bring in bearer, and here we have to bring in our specific token. For us, we just go here, copy our API key to the clipboard, head on back and paste it in where it said token. So bearer, token, but the token is our personalized token. I'm gonna have to keep that blurred out. Obviously that's private. You don't wanna share that information with anyone else. Now we are getting into the URL parameters. Remember, the actual URL over here is actually a little bit longer. It includes the name of the company as well as the domain of the company. And then you can see inside of this that we are actually passing through values. Well, we get that same result by inside of Smart Suite identifying URL parameters. These have to match exactly as the API is expecting. So I'm copying the two values here: name, all lowercase, domain, all lowercase, and I'm adding these into our URL parameters, name and domain. And here's where I'm able to bring in the information from the specific record. So I'm saying I want to take whatever company name in Smart Suite we already got. And same thing with the website here. We already have the website for these companies. I'm plugging it in here. That way it's getting passed along in our webhook action step. Now for the magic. So far, all we've done is built up the send information. We've sent this information that we currently have, and now we need to do the get part. What are we getting out of this? In order to understand this part, it's best to go over here and look at the documentation. I've opened this up in a new window, and we can see an example response here. Here's all of the different information that we're going to get, and it's inside of these various objects. You can see that with the curly brackets, what we are receiving. We get a lot of data, starting with the name of the company, all the way down into calls to action, various locations, specialties, all of this information, funding data. I mean, there's a lot here. We can pull all of this back, and we need to break it out individually so that we can take it and use it in the next steps. So let's refresh our memories about what information we're looking for here. I've built a very high level example for us. Let's save our automation and go back to our actual data. And right here, we will see that we are looking for the followers, which again is a number. And then we're looking for the company type, which is text. If we head back into the API documentation, we're going to see the followers right here presents a number. And then if we look for company type, we'll see it down here. It's just called type. And it returns that it's a public company, might also return private company or whatever different type of organization. So this is the information we need to use to enrich our records. So these are the two things we are looking to capture. We have to know what type of data it is and the name of the data. So here we're looking for followers, and I'll show you how to build this inside of Smart Suite. In the automation, let's go back to it now. We'll open up the webhook action again, and down here, we are saying in the response type that we are looking for these variables. Let me actually erase these and we will build them ourselves again from scratch. We simply say select field, and we have to identify the type of data that we're getting. For us, we know followers is a number, so I'm going to select number and bring in followers here. Let's go ahead and save that, and we'll head back to the documentation. Again, I need to match followers exactly, case sensitivity and everything. Next, I'm going to bring in type. Remember, this is a returning text. So back into Smart Suite we go. We select our field, select the type, the field type, and bring in the property name, and we save it. So these two elements have now been added. We can see that we have the followers and the type of company returning in both a number and text fields respectively. And of course, if we have an error, this is what will happen. We can either mark this as a success and just move on, or we can say, no, if we don't get this data, let's have a fail flag on the field. Once we're set up to collect the information that we need, we can click out and we can test it up here in the upper right. This is going to take just a moment, and of course it's going to ask us to manually put in some information. So let's go with Google, and I'll say google.com. Let's run our test, and we're going to see the API thinking in the background. This is going to take just a moment or two. Let's go ahead and pause, and we'll pick it back up in just a minute. There it is. Not too bad. We didn't have to wait all that long, but we get our full response body. This is the raw body, lots of information, and let's be honest, that's a wall of text. Pretty hard to use. Thank goodness we broke out the answers we're looking for. So here we can see the number of followers as well as the type of company, just as was displayed on the previous screen. So now that we have this information kind of broken out for us, we can use it in the next step. And here's where things get really helpful. We can simply update the record inside a Smart Suite. I'm going to update the company based on whatever trigger we are looking at here. And we are going to update the followers. And we are going to update the company type. Remember, we broke both of these pieces out from the previous step, so we can bring in that dynamic data from the webhook request, and I'm looking for followers here, and here I'm looking for the company type, again, from the second step, from the action, and I'm looking for type. Lastly, I want to toggle off the switch for updating data. Right, because we had to toggle this on in order to initiate the automation, and now I want to turn it to no. So every time this automation runs, I'm going to find these two pieces of information about this particular client or company. I'm going to update it in Smart Suite, and I'm going to then turn the toggle back on to show us that we have achieved the results we're looking for. Let's go ahead and save this automation now, and of course turn it on and give it a test. I'm back inside of my database now. I've got Disney, Disney.com. Let's send this information to enrich.so and see if we can pull back the number of followers and the type of company, which I imagine is public for Disney. There you have it. You see that now on my screen, update data has been toggled back off because it's completed the automation. We have 5.8 million followers and a company of public. We can do this for Amazon and Google as well and return their information. And of course, Smart Suite's automations are robust enough to be able to show us the history as well. So we can always go back into our automation and click on history. You're going to see my failed automations here from earlier and also my successful runs and the current run as well. You can always open this up, look at the details and figure out what's going on. But back here, we're already going to see results for Amazon and Google as well. Really, really powerful stuff, being able to have webhook actions now natively available inside of Smart Suite. I know this can be a little bit heavy working with webhooks, so if you need some extra help, feel free to swing by our website and find the resource for you. Of course, if you got value from this video, we'd love a thumbs up and a subscription to the channel, but most importantly, keep on building.